Paris.
Yes?
Come here. There's been something I've always been wanting to ask.
Yes?
Your name.
My name, Lord?
Your name, Paris. I mean, it's a bit odd, is it not? You must name yourself after a city. Why not call yourself something domestic? Rome, Sicily, don't you?
But look you, sir. Your daughter consents.
Oh, Julie, darling, that dress does become you well. Would that I could answer thyself, Maria.
Juliet, your gown brings out a quality of beauty the likes of which I have never seen.
Thank you. I can't go through with this.
Right the way to behave at one's own wedding.
Oh, I do agree. What could have prompted such a reaction?
Well, if I were to be married to a man such as Paris, then there was the rest of my life in front of me.
Shut up thy mouth, Maria.
Sir, your daughter is dead. Poisoned by her own hand.
Dreadfully embarrassed.
Upon my life, that was your father's time.
If that's it, I deserve her.
My love taken from me so soon. What tragedy will happen next?
By the laws of Verona, I protest this marriage.
Protest on what ground?
On the ground that Romeo has married Juliet already.
What is this rubbish?
Too late, Montague. She's dead.
Dead? Dead?
Romeo, what dost thou do?
I shall take my life with this poison I did buy in Mantua.
What? Where am I?
Juliet.
Juliet, what is the meaning of this?
I'll explain later.
Juliet.
Romeo.
Mother! Father! What goes on here? The banished Romeo did have the nerve to come back to disrupt my daughter's wedding.
Thou hast said that he should die upon return, so it does seem only fitting.
Oh, do stop thy foolish entreaties upon my good son's life.
Yes, the life of our son had it more value than this ridiculous feud.
But my good cousin Mercutio is still dead. As long as he remains that way, I cannot let Romeo Montague go free.
Well then, let him go.
We do return to life.
I'm high spirits, yes, but by no means a ghost.
We beg the fight to engineer the outcome here tonight.
Oh, but wasn't it I that killed you?
Really? Didst thou think me so feeble of foe?
So let the feud cease.
And let the marriage start.
Paris, what can I say? Tough luck, old man.
Well, I must admit I've often admired you from afar.
Well, I suppose I could live with that.
Could you learn to live with me?
No problem.
What's going on here? Speak up!
Thank you.
Evanston.